How many photos and videos do you have on your phone? It's a fun exercise. Let's look. I have 57,408 assets on my phone library. That sounds like a lot, but the best part is, sometime over the past several years, we all learned that when we need to find something, even lost in tens of thousands of assets, AI has been quietly analyzing these elements in the background, and a quick search makes filtered results fast and easy to locate. Think about it. We can all search for tens of thousands of assets on devices like this and filter by locations, objects, words, and even familiar faces. And with a click or two, we can share the filtered results with someone else. Why can't I do that with professional tools? It's time for storytellers to have the same control, speed, and simplicity that consumers enjoy. And artificial intelligence and machine learning are perfectly poised to make this a reality. This is one of the main reasons that we started our AI workflow company, Strada. So how did this happen? Well, we'll start with a production where logging is critical.
Welcome to Camp Cash. Two contestants thrown into the heart of an abandoned summer camp turned rugged wilderness, where survival meets competition. Amidst nature's unpredictable obstacles and our producer's mischievous challenges, our contestants are searching for hidden treasure worth $50,000.
The production is captured over multiple days with a small crew and intercuts confessional interviews with challenges that the contestants have to overcome.
Oh, at this point I'm still on track, you know?
Hey! Hey! Is that coffee?
I was just acting that way for the drama of the show.
Ah, these blisties.
And we will be right back.
Ah.
When shooting unscripted shows like this, there's typically a camera crew, sometimes specific crews that follow specific storylines. With them are story producers and coordinators who help ensure the camera team is capturing all the material needed to tell the story, as well as ensure everyone is safe, and whether scripted or unscripted, there's a good story that editors will be able to find and flesh out in post.
Let's take a look at what Beck is up to.
Richard's riddle is the other half of mine, which means I now have a leg up on finding the prize.
But oftentimes in unscripted situations, the biggest problem is that the people on location who know what happened are not always part of the post-production process. The crew have a memory of the time and place something happened. And while coordinators will make notes to identify key points of interest, there isn't an easy way to get all of that information to the people in post who weren't there to witness it. In this case, with 545 assets and more than a dozen hours of media to deal with, logging is a necessary step in order for editors and story producers to start cutting the story down into its best parts. And that means before we can get to the fun stuff of storytelling, we have to do all the boring stuff of logging. Now, there's always value when someone takes the time to log assets. Most of the time, logging is done in post by a post-production assistant, and they traditionally use a nonlinear editor to log assets and then organize the results into bins so things can be easily searched for by editors later. Some NLEs have robust tools to log things quickly, like Final Cut's single-click mappable keyword collections tool, or Premiere and Resolve, which have custom fields in which you can log scene and take data, descriptions, comments, or even color codes. So how much time does logging actually save? Well, I think it can depend on a few factors. First, before you can save any time, you have to calculate how much time you're willing to put into a logging pass. Second, the type of production you're working on can impact how effective logging is. And third, the density of logging impacts how effective a search may be. If all three of these are done well, you should save time in the editing process. So let's start with issue one. Calculating how much time you're willing to put into logging will always vary. But I would argue that on projects, if you don't log at all, you end up spending more time throughout the edit doing the logging by way of searching and scrubbing more often than if you did at least a preliminary log up front. This project has 545 clips in it. The total runtime of media here is 13 hours and 6 minutes. One way to make this efficient is to identify groups of clips that have similar characteristics and log them in a batch. So let's look at our show. We can see through thumbnails a group of clips that are all shot at night. I could make a keyword collection for night, quickly tag them, and now even when I go to my 545 source clips, I can click night and it will auto-filter them down. That's a good start. But what if I wanted to be a bit more specific on the material? Let's say I needed to find all the elements that are shot by the lake. Well, I could start scanning through. Okay, there's one. Here's a bunch. There's a few more. And I could hunt and peck around and multi-select them and then add these to the lake collection. Searching through thumbnails is a little less accurate and a little slower, but this should be somewhat helpful later. But what if I wanted to go even deeper? When a producer says, I need a shot of the woman contestant backpacking. Well, that's gonna be hard. I don't even know if there is a visible backpack in a thumbnail in all this media. Oh wait, okay, that looks like one, but is this the only backpack of the whole shoot? And I don't see the woman here. To find more, it's gonna take a while. And if we were superheroes and could keep this up and log all 545 assets with an average of 30 seconds per asset, that's 16,350 seconds of logging, which without a break is a total of 4.5 hours. Now, a half day's work seems reasonable to get this into a decent spot with this technique, but that brings us to the second issue, which is the type of production you're logging, meaning the efficiency of logging may vary from an unscripted show like this versus a narrative production.
Scene one, take 40, be common, Mark.
Quiet, please. Action.
Hello?
This production is called Rattle. For narrative projects, the most valuable search information is typically the scene and take information. Since we have slates for every single setup and every camera, we can manually log this information into our NLE. And while we're at it, maybe we'll help the editor out a bit by going a bit further, possibly logging a location, like the kitchen, or maybe a key prop, like the knife or fruit. Rattled actually has some animals in it. We've got a pet cat, okay, cute, and a pet rat, okay. So maybe we spend some time tagging a few of these key elements because since this is a script, these elements are already known to the story. But if we go back to our unscripted show, this becomes really difficult because so much of the story is unknown until it actually happens, which brings us to the last issue of how logging density impacts how effective a search can be. The problem with this is that when you log, you subconsciously, unknowingly insert your own biases. For example, in a shot like this, you might be so focused on the act of these contestants being blindfolded that you forget to tag that they're being forced into a van. In other words, when you're logging clips for someone else, it doesn't mean that they will necessarily search for the same words, which lowers value of the time invested in logging altogether. In this clip, we see both contestants together getting ready to start the contest. So we might tag them as male and female. We also see the lake in the background and tag it. And there's a wooden structure here. So we've just tagged male, female, lake, and wood. But if someone were to search man and woman and water and fence, the searcher gets zero results and the time spent logging isn't helpful at all. So that means when we initially log, we may need to log male, man, and adult, then female and woman, then water, pond, lake, sea, ocean, fence, wood, structure, posts, and now you see the problem that's been plaguing post-production teams forever. Just like that, in order to widen the probability of accurate searches, we had to apply 15 tags to represent only 3 elements. Multiply that by 545 shots of varying length, and there's no way a human can provide an accurate, high-density set of searchable tags in any reasonable amount of time. But a machine, well, that's a different story.
And now, back to our show.
I found a red string, so I pulled it and pulled it and pulled it. And I was sure I had found the treasure.
To find the cache, scurry fast amongst the chill and saplings.
Damn it. But it's okay. This just gets me closer and closer.
So here we are in Strada. What we're building here is the first AI-powered workflow engine that's designed for creative professionals and lives entirely in the cloud. I can log in my Frame.io account where all the Cache Camp dailies are already stored. I can browse through all my footage, and if I want to log my footage, all I need to do is select all my assets and then right-click and hit Tag Analyze. And with one click, I can kick off an AI analysis model that will search all my clips and automatically tag objects, locations, props, people, notable actions, and even some emotions. And just like your phone, this is a 100% background task, and it has literally zero impact on your local machine. So you're free to do anything else while this complex task is happening. As clips are analyzed, they instantly become available to search so I can start auditing my results. I can do this across assets in Frame.io, Google Drive, or Dropbox. So let's see how it did. So in this bin, with all 545 assets, we searched night. We already determined that one's easy. But let's search by lake, Well, we can easily see our lake shots, but when I look at these thumbnails, some of them don't appear to have a lake in them. So what does that mean? Well, if I click on the asset, navigate to the Analysis tab, and then reveal it, on the left, I see a list of what the AI was able to detect in the clip. And if I look on the right, I see a map of where the AI was able to see it. And even though the shot begins in what looks like a forest, as we play on, we see the exact time code where the lake was identified, and we see our shot of the lake. Let's look at some other takes. You'll notice that some of these clips have over 50 tags in them. That's because AI has a deep search density. This means if I search by water instead of lake, I get the same results. This helps me trust the tags and makes searching for the keywords easier. So what happens when we search for something harder, like backpacking? Well, with that search, I got several assets, some with thumbnails that help, as in moments like this, but not all the thumbnails are helpful. So that's where I can trust the tag. If I click on this asset, I can see in the analysis, backpacking, and it's tagged, but the location of the action appears only in a small section of the clip. And right about there, we see the action of backpacking. Searching by actions is great because editors are often finding themselves cutting and need to fill a space with a specific action. So let's say I need a shot of the woman hiking. Now I can search hiking plus woman and I get some results and simply scrub to the moment the hiking takes place. If I were looking for shots where the contest begins, one person might know the backpacks were there, so I could search backpacks and find the right moments. But what if someone only knew that the location of the start was near cabins? I could search for cabin, and because the backpacks and cabins are tagged together in some of these clips, I get slightly different results, but they still led me to the moments of the show that I was looking for.
Camp Cash is about to begin. In 3, 2, 1, go!
So what happens if we apply the same tag analyze AI technology to the rattled film? Well, if I was editing and needed inserts of the knife, I can easily search by knife and be shown all the times the knife shows up. In some cases, it was with the main unit, shooting the knife during a multicam synced sound take. But I'm also getting tags from second unit, which captured images of drawers of knives, and now I don't have to hunt and peck for them. And what if I wanted to search cat? Well, we can see all the takes where the cat's visible and quickly scrub past the empty parts because we already know where the cat's going to show up. And I can search for ring and find the takes in which that tiny object is visible. And while we're at it, let's search for the rat. And we see some obvious takes where the rat is here. But wait a second. Here's a couple of clips where I don't recognize the rat and I don't think the rat is visible at all. Let's check the analysis. No, no rat tagged. So why did Strada surface these clips when I searched for rat? Well, if I click on the transcription tool, I see that rat is actually spoken. So Strada's AI is surfacing rat in both visible and audible forms, which makes search density even more reliable. So it's clear that AI tagging is going to be much faster than a human. Being able to search in Strada means anyone on your creative team can participate in the storytelling experience without being tied to an NLE. But how do I get this information into an NLE where an editor can actually use it? Well, in an upcoming episode, we're gonna show you how AI tagging performed within Strada can be imported directly into your NLE. This approach to tagging and analyzing is totally new, and it's only gonna get better. So if you think this will help your workflow, we invite you to sign up for Strada at strada.tech and then send us an email at beta@strada.tech, and we'll add you to the wait list. As we roll out our AI workflow technology, we're looking for people who understand what was just demonstrated and see how big a deal it is. And we want to find people who want to be early adopters of the program.